Hi folks, welcome back to one of the little videos that I'm going to do, and today we're going to talk about the difference between power and energy. If you cannot contain your curiosity, here we go. I'm going to start talking about this old bulb. It's an old-fashioned tungsten filament bulb. Nowadays we think of them as really inefficient, and its rating, its power rating, is 100 watts. So if we want to switch that bulb on, we would use 100 watts of energy every hour. That's the energy that it would consume. We're not going to do it with that. We're going to do it with this little baby. This is a new LED bulb and it's rated at 10 watts. So that's a tenth of that, obviously. And so if we want to have light with that, we go, let there be light. With this bulb alight, the 100 watt bulb, if we have it on for 1 hour, that is 100 watt hours. Watt hours is energy, and with this one we would only use 10 watts if it is left over an hour. That's 10 watt hours. Power is the rating, watt hours is the energy consumed. Right, we're going to move on, because let's try and look at what 1 kilowatt hour is, because that's the way we tend to measure electricity in our homes. So I am going to weave my magic spell again and say, let there be light. We now have 10 watt bulbs going, so the rating is 100 watts power. Okay, that's the power needed. And if we have 10 watt bulbs on for an hour, that will be the same as having one of these on for an hour. They both would use 100 watt hours. And if we leave this wonderful array on for 10 hours, that is 10 times 100, which is 1,000. That is the kilowatt hour. So that would be the energy consumed if we leave all 10 watt bulbs on for 10 hours. Got it? Fantastic. We're now going to talk in a little bit more detail about how this relates to nuclear power stations. Ah, thank you. Just to recap, we've got one bulb and its power rating is 10 watts. Power. If we switch it on, that one 10 watt bulb, we leave it on for 1 hour, that is 10 watt hours of electrical energy consumed. And then we moved on to our 10 watt bulbs, and if we put them on for 1 hour, that's 100 watt hours of energy. And if we have our 10 bulbs of 10 watts on for 10 hours, that's 1000 watt hours, or 1 kilowatt hour. We can also look at an electrical kettle. Now, kettles have a much higher rating, a power rating typically of anything between 2 and 3 kilowatts. Now, I timed the electrical kettle in the kitchen here. It took 3 minutes to boil. So 3 minutes divided by 60 minutes for the hour, that's 1/20th of an hour. 3 kilowatts times 1/20th is 0.15 kilowatt hours. If you do 10 boils, that's 1.5 kilowatt hours. Quickly need to look at the units of power, and we have already talked about the watt, and we've talked about how 1,000 watts is 1 kilowatt, 1,000 kilowatts is 1 megawatt, 1,000 megawatts is 1 gigawatt, and 1,000 gigawatts is 1 terawatt. And when we have something that is rated such for 1 hour, we have 1 kilowatt hour, 1 megawatt hour, a gigawatt hour and a terawatt hour. Now typically for nuclear power stations we'll tend to talk about megawatts and gigawatts, and for annual electricity consumption we'll talk about terawatt hour. So looking at Bradwell, which we now call Bradwell A, its power rating was 242 megawatts. That was the power it was capable of producing. It was originally rated at 300 megawatts, but they had to downgrade it because of some issues. And over its lifespan of 40 years, it produced just under 60 terawatt hours of electricity. If we look at one of the current fleet of nuclear reactors in Torness, this is an advanced gas core reactor, an AGR, that's 1190 megawatts, 1190 megawatts, and in gigawatts that's 1.19 gigawatts. Similarly, Sizewell B, this is the latest nuclear power station that's being built in the country, and this has one reactor that is capable of producing enough heat for two turbine runs, and the electrical power rating is round about 1200 megawatts, 1198 megawatts, or 1.198 gigawatts. And this is a quick table which I will put up on your screen, a link to it, and also have it in the description of the current nuclear fleet. And the brand new projects, Hinkley Point C is the only one that's been started, and it uses something called an EPR, that's an European pressurized reactor, and this is supposed to be the same model that they're looking at for Sizewell C. We of course hope that neither of these will happen. Anyway, there are two reactors and they're 1600 megawatts each, 1600 megawatts each, or 3.2 gigawatts in total. Bradwell is slightly different. If we look at the old Magnox reactor, that was the 242 megawatts that we talked about earlier. This uses a different reactor designed by CGN, the Chinese company, and there are two reactors of 1150 megawatts each, making a total for the two reactors of 2.3 gigawatts. This is the current situation right as we speak, the day that I filmed this, and the generation by the various systems that make up the UK electricity mix, it's 30.8 gigawatts, and the carbon, which is a matter for a future episode, is 105 grams equivalent of carbon dioxide per kilowatt hour of generation. The app for that, I'll put the link up here and have it in the description as well. This is the last 12 months of electricity generation in the UK, and this is terawatt hours, and so you can see what the totals are for the different key components of the electricity mix. This is a fantastic site. And as I say, the link will be available for you to use, and also you can check out my other video all about this. So just going right back to the recap, power is the power rating. If you have a 10 watt bulb, that is its power rating. If you leave a 10 watt bulb on for a period of time, in terms of hours, it becomes the energy consumed. So I do hope that's been helpful. We are moving on towards this discussion about low carbon, and it was essential that we talk about the different units of power and of energy ready in preparation. Please click on the link on the blob to subscribe, leave a comment should you wish, and I really hope to see you next time. Carry on keeping safe. All the best. Let there be light.